Hello students, my name is Bhavna Singh. I am working as an assistant professor in St. Andrews Institute of Technology and Management. This is an online tutorial series on e-commerce. So let's begin today's session. Students, these are the topics of Unit 2 that we will discuss in today's session. That is, the first one is, what is security policy? What are the various objectives and elements of security policy? What is integrated security and what are the various benefits of integrated security? So let's begin with today's session. Now the first topic for today's session is, what is a security policy? A security policy is a written statement describing which assets to protect and why they are being protected, who is responsible for that protection, which behaviors are acceptable and which are not. So basically, security policy is a kind of a written document in an organization which outlines how to protect the organization from various threats, including computer security threats, you can say, and how to handle these situations when these kinds of threats occur. So it is maintained by every company in order to protect their assets as well as in order to prevent the potential threats to those assets. So therefore, company employees, they need to be kept updated on the company's security policies, and these policies should be updated regularly also. And all the things like the physical address, the physical security, the network security, access authorizations, virus protection, disaster recovery, all these things, they are primarily addressed in the security policy, and it provides all the rules and regulations that must be followed by an organization and all the employees of that particular organizations. So basically, in this written document, everything is mentioned that we need to what assets to protect and why to protect them, and who is responsible for all those protection, or which behaviors of the employees or which behaviors of the companies are acceptable by the company or not. So all these things, they should be mentioned in that security policy, and they are updated on regular intervals also. For example, when a company stores the customer's credit card, so it becomes the asset for that company, that it is the responsibility of that company to protect that credit card numbers or any transaction details or any customer personal details to protect them from unauthorized access. So therefore, they determine various resources also that can be used to protect these assets. So in order to protect all these things or all these information, they develop a written security policy, that is a written document in which everything is mentioned, and they provide the resources also that must be required to implement these security policies. Now we will discuss the characteristics of security policy. The first one is, information security policy should be end to end. That means this security policy inside the organization, it should secure the company or the organization from all the ends. Like, it should cover all the software, hardware devices or human resources, information, data that is present, access control, etc. All these things, they should be secured within an organization. So it has to be ensured that no one can access these data or no one can tamper with all these devices. Then the second one is, it should have a room for revision and updates. See what happens, organizations, they do not remain the same every time. They will change or they will grow over a period of time. So according to that growth, these policies, they need to be revised at fixed intervals, and all these updates or all these revisions, they must be approved and documented by the authorized persons. So they should be updated at regular intervals. So it should be ensured that new updates are addressed in the policies whenever there is a change in the organization or whenever there is a growth in the organization. Then the third one is, it should incorporate the risk assessment of the organization. That means the security policy, it should ensure that all the identified risks, they are taken care in the information security policy, and it should include a risk assessment method in order to identify the potential hazards or potential risk, because it is very easy to tamper any information or to tamper with any devices. So it should include all the risk assessment factors as well. Then the last one is, it should be practical and enforceable. That means the security policy within an organization, it should be practical enough so that we can implement any changes that are practically possible. And it should address all the issues effectively and must have an exception process in place so that all the requirements or all the things, they can be implemented easily. Now the next question is, why the security policy is required? The security policy helps to provide guidance for staff around acceptable use of devices and online material so that they understand the important role they play in protecting your business security. First of all, it describes all the practices that should be followed by all the employees inside the customer, that what are their roles and responsibilities, and what are their responsibilities regarding protection of assets, regarding protection of confidential information, and what behaviors they are acceptable or what not. So in order to guide them, it is very much important. Secondly, many customers, they do not trust easily any e-commerce website because of this theft and stealing of personal information or theft of their credit card information like this. So they do not build any trust easily, and because of this only they hesitate in buying and selling goods or services on the any e-commerce website. So in order to make them understand and in order to build their trust, it is very much important, because it will help you to build the customer's confidence in your business. And if they know that this particular organization is implementing some kind of security policy and all these things they are implemented inside the business, so it is your responsibility to make them aware that whatever information they are providing on your website, or whatever credit card numbers or any transaction details or any personal information they are providing on your website, so it is your responsibility to protect those assets. So therefore, you must make them understand, or you must build the trust in them, that whatever they are providing on your website, it should be protected with the help of all these security policies, so that they'll be able to do the online transactions, or they'll be able to buy or sell goods online without any hesitation. So therefore, it is required the security policy to implement inside every business. Now, what are the objectives of security policy? The objectives of a security policy is the preservation of confidentiality, integrity, and availability of systems and informations used by an organization's members. So basically, the most important objective of the security policy is to prevent these CIA triad, that is confidentiality, integrity, and availability. Confidentiality means protecting your confidential information or protecting your assets from any unauthorized users. Then the integrity, it ensures the modification of asset is handled in a specified and authorized manner, and whatever information the customer is providing or whatever information is available, it is not modified in any manner. Then the availability means that authorized users, they have the continuous access to the assets, and whatever information they required, it is available without any delay or without any denial. So all these CIA triad, that is confidentiality, integrity, and availability, is the responsibility of a security policy to maintain. Now we will discuss about the basic requirements that every security policy must fulfill. Number one is the secrecy. Secrecy means the privacy or the confidentiality. That means preventing any unauthorized persons from reading your messages or your credit card numbers or any other confidential information. Then the second is integrity. Integrity means that a communication that is received or any information that is received, it has not been altered or tampered with in any manner. That means any modification is not done with the data. Then the third, we have the availability. Availability means ensuring access to a resources. That means it provides all the delivery assurance for each message, so that the messages or any message segment that cannot be lost. Whenever the customer requires, all the information is available without any delay. Then we have the next is key management. Key management, it provides the secure distribution and management of keys that are needed to provide the secure communication. Like in case of encryption, we have the private keys and public keys. So for the security purpose only, we encrypt the personal information into certain other information. So this is the management of keys is required in order to provide the secure communications between the parties. Then we have the non-repudiation. Non-repudiation means it provides end-to-end proof of each message origin and recipient. That means who is the sender and who is the receiver, everything is provided. Then the next we have the authentication. Authentication means it identifies the clients and servers with the help of digital signatures, you can say, or with the help of digital certificates, so that we'll be able to, or we ensure that the whatever information is coming or whatever message is coming, it is coming from some authentic persons. With the help of these digital signatures and with the help of these digital certificates, we'll be able to identify the authenticity of that particular person. So all these things, they are the basic requirements that every security policy should fulfill in order to build the trust of the customer, so that they can be easily trust your company and they'll be easily, you can easily include them or include or attract more and more customers towards your business. Now we will discuss about the various elements of security policy. See, these elements, they are important or they are documented because in order to enhance the trust among the users. So in order to build confidence and in order to make them trustworthy, the security policy needs to implement all these elements. So the first one is the security definition. Security definition means we are providing the entire strategy, or you can say this security definition element, it includes a well-defined vision for the organization and it provides the customers that what is the intent of the policy in ensuring the confidentiality or integrity and availability of all the data or resources and how they can be used effectively. Then the next we have the enforcement. Enforcement means this security policy, it identifies how various incidents or how various information or resources or all those policies that are mentioned in this security policy or all those responsibilities that are present in this, how they are handled in an appropriate manner, or it also describes that how all these enforcement will be applied so that we'll not able to suffer from any kind of theft. Then the next we have the user access to computer resources. Now this element of security policy, it provides the roles or the responsibilities for various users who are accessing the resources that are present on the network of the company. So it provides all the individual roles and responsibilities to the users so that they can access or they can control all the acts or all the resources in an authorized manner. Then the next we have the authentication. This authentication element, it describes that who is trying to access the website of the e-commerce company. Then the next we have the access control. Access control means this element, it provides that whoever is allowed to log on or who can access the electronic website or who has got all the access control so that he'll be able to access all the resources or information that is present on the website. Then the next is the secrecy. Secrecy, it describes that who is permitted to view all the secret, or you can say who is responsible to have access to the confidential information. Then the next element is the data integrity. Data integrity may, it describes that who is allowed to change any data or to do any modifications or who is not allowed to get access to these information. Then the next we have the audit. Audit means who or what causes selected events to occur and when. Means who is responsible to make some events or to select some events to occur, or who is not responsible for all these kinds of audits. Now the next topic comes, that is integrated security. What is an integrated security? An integrated security is a security strategy that leverages a common set of configurations, rules, policies and practices to secure all of an organization's workloads. This integrated security, it provides a unified solution for every type of service. That means this integrated security system, it provides a basis, or you can say the best way to keep your companies safe by providing various strategies or by providing various plans, so that we'll be able to protect our website. Because what happens in these kind of security, integrated security systems, these are implemented by almost all of the companies. And what these systems provide, they provide or they uses various components. And they uses a layered system consisting of various audio based intrusion detection, or they provide alarm notification, or a commercial access control, or you can say fire and smoke detection, or video monitoring. So all these basic strategies or all these planning, they can be implemented by various companies in order to protect their important assets, or in order to protect their all the data or information that is present on their website, which is a confidential, and it is very much important for every organization to protect those data, because the customer, after trusting these e-commerce websites, they have placed an order and they have provided you with all the confidential information. So it is your responsibility to protect them. So therefore, in order to protect all these assets, every e-commerce website, they integrate some kind of integrated security system. Now, these are the basic benefits of an integrated security. The first one is proactive identification of risk. That means by applying various multiple security solutions, the companies will be able to focus on the detection or the eventual resolution of threats as they are provided or as they are opposed to the proactive solutions offered by these integrated security. And what will happen after applying these integrated security, it will block all the threats from a wide range of sources, or we'll be able to identify in advance only. Then the second, we have the scalability. That means these integrated security policies that we apply inside a company, they are highly scalable, and these models, they can ensure that the applications are safe, and they prevent a waste of time and resources by providing a multiple layers of protection. Then the next, we have time and money. These integrated security models, they save the time and money of a company by providing automation of updates and every monitoring security issues from a single platform. It also reduces cost and makes more efficient the system overall, and it provides the security more efficiently to a particular system. Now students, these are the important questions based on today's session, and it is important for you all to prepare these, as these are important from the examination point of view also. So the first one is, what is the need of security policy in a business? And the second is, what do you understand by integrated security and what are its various benefits? So students, it was all about today. We are ending our session here only. I hope you have understood all the concepts well. In the next session, we will start with the e-commerce security threats like client threats, communication channel threats, and server threats. Till then, you all take care of yourself and keep learning. Thank you so much for watching.